10 years ago, people lined up to buy the first iPhone. No one knew then what we would know now, and that is that it would change the way we live and it would change the business world. It created entire industries while crippling some others. Josh Lipton takes a look at the device's impact on just about everything.
An iPod, a phone, and an internet communicator. An iPod. A phone. Are you getting it?
Not even Steve Jobs could have known just how transformative this device would be. Apple has sold more than 1 billion iPhones, and its flagship product now accounts for the majority of its sales. The iPhone didn't just reinvent Apple. The product upended and redefined many markets. It put an end to the flip phone, and it made the once ubiquitous BlackBerry all but obsolete. It also created an app economy that is now valued at more than $1 trillion. And it's that app store that helped fuel the growth of so many young, mobile-first companies from Snap to Uber.
So what do consumers want to see from the iPhone 10 years from now?
FaceTiming should be multi-way, like conference call.
I want it to be able to test for carcinogens in the air, carcinogens in the food, making sure that air quality is good.
I would not like it to be integrated into the human body, as I've heard some people say will happen.
This anniversary comes at a critical time for Apple, with iPhone sales coming off their first year of decline, but investors have high hopes for that latest version of the iPhone expected in the fall. For Nightly Business Report, I'm Josh Lipton, San Francisco.